Welcome to GTV. Today I will be showing you encoders from Dynapar. I have with me absolute and incremental encoders. The incremental encoders provide a specified amount of pulses in one rotation of the encoder. The output can be a single line of pulses or two lines of pulses that are offset in order to determine rotation. This phasing between the two signals is called quadrature. The typical assembly of an incremental encoder consists of a spindle assembly, PCB, and cover. The PCB contains a sensor array that creates just two primary signals for the purpose of position and speed. They can provide excellent speed and distance feedback with a more simple and economical system. An absolute encoder determines its position using a static reference point. They have overall resolution and orientation with a better startup performance because of the low homing time. There are two disks, both with concentric rings with offset markers. One disk is fixed to the central shaft as the other moves freely. As the disk turns, the markers along the track of absolute encoders change position on the fixed disk. Each configuration along the disk of an absolute rotary encoder represents a unique binary code. Looking at the binary code within the absolute rotary encoder determines the absolute position of the object. The devices in the absolute encoders are available with different communication protocols for providing feedback data. Dynapar encoders, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at galco.com.